Hello children, hope you all are fine by the grace of God. Students, I need your cooperation to smoothly undergo this online session. So keep your English books, notebooks, pens and pencils with you.
Students, this is your English book number 5. So from here, your first chapter of PT2, that is chapter number 9, Little Green Men, is already over. Today, let's start with your second chapter of PT2, that is chapter number 10, Pepper the Capuchin Monkey. So everyone, open your English book number 5, page number 8, chapter number 10, Pepper the Capuchin Monkey. Children, before starting this chapter, you underline the difficult words given in your books with your pencils and write down the meanings of these words given in your books with your pens in your notebooks. So let's begin. Let's read this story about a girl and her unique pet. Okay, so children, at the very beginning only, from the title of the chapter, we are coming to know that it is Pepper the Capuchin Monkey. So, this chapter basically deals with the monkey. Let's read to find out everything in detail about this Pepper the Capuchin Monkey. I was fuming all around me, my classmates bragged. A talking parrot, said Meera Gupta. A hatchful of rabbits, said Uma Joshi. A pair of highly pedigreed twin Persian cats purred Sadhna Mehra, so pleased with herself. And I fumed. And what pet did I have? An ancient dog who just slept and ate and sometimes ate and slept to alter his routine? And what about you, dear? Tell us something about your pet. All eyes turned to me in eager anticipation. Okay, so children, there was a girl who used to go to school. One day at her class, everyone was being asked regarding their pets. That is, whoever has whatever pets, they are being asked to say something regarding their pets. So, most of the classmates of the girl, they were talking about their pets. That is, a girl called Meera Gupta, she had a talking parrot. Another girl called Uma Joshi, she had a hutch full of rabbits. Okay. Again, another one whose name is Sadhna Mehra, she had a pair of highly pedigreed twin Persian cats. So you see, most of the friends of that girl were having lots and lots of pets, and who are not just simple pets. They are either pedigreed, which are of pure breed, and very highly sophisticated pets. But you know what? That little girl, she actually had an ancient dog whose only work was just to sleep and eat, and also to eat and sleep to alter his routine. The little girl was not feeling good to share regarding the pet dog to her classmates. Okay. So, when she was asked about what kind of pet do you have, that little girl was a bit worried. Because as I have told you, she was not in a mood to share anything about her ancient dog. So let's read to find out what she shares. A monkey, I said hesitantly. It slipped out, rolled off the smoothest tongue. Ah, good the girls. I had lived up to their highest expectations. How unique, exclaimed Miss Subbu. Do come to the front of the class and tell us all about it. Okay. So children, as soon as the little girl was being asked regarding her pet, and as I had already told you that she was not in a mood to say anything about her pet, which was nothing but an ancient dog, accidentally it slipped out of her tongue that she had a monkey. Now when everyone heard that she had a monkey as a pet, everyone was astonished to know that. And Miss Subbu, that is their teacher, she asked her to come in front of the class and say everything in detail about her unique pet, that is the monkey. Now if there's one thing I am more of an expert at than wildlife, it is the art of telling tall tales. Standing before a class full of goggle-eyed girls, Pepper, the capuchin monkey, was born. She was light brown with a dark head. Her perky pink ears let no sound past them. She was fond of old baggy t-shirts. She had an insatiable appetite for instant coffee powder and had learned to unscrew the bottle top and stick a wetted finger in to attain a lick full of this prized possession. On inquiry, I told my classmates that capuchins were a South American breed of primates. Where did I get Pepper? An uncle had been presented one when he had gone on an expedition to look for undiscovered tribes of South America. I rattled on, getting quite caught up in my own fantasy. After the bell rang, I was surrounded by girls and inundated by their intrigued questions. Why didn't you ever tell us before? Well, I didn't want to show off, you know. What does she eat? Where does she sleep? How old is she? And then the inevitable, oh please, when can we see her? Don't ask me how I wriggled out of that one, but I did, for the time being at least. Okay, children, now it was her time to explain everything in detail about the monkey. Okay, and she was very much expert in saying false things because she was a kind of fantasy preferred girl whose imagination skills were very high. So standing in front of the class, she started saying everything about the monkey by her imagination. Okay, so she had told that monkey, her name was Pepper. She has kept that monkey's name as Pepper, and it was not a simple monkey. It was a capuchin monkey. Okay, why was it called a capuchin monkey? Because her color was light brown with a dark head. Like cappuccino coffees, you all know very well, isn't it? Coffees, cappuccino coffees are what? They are light brown colored, and also the down portions, they are dark in color. So as the capuchin monkey's color was same as that of cappuccino coffee. And she was fond of old baggy t-shirts. Means the monkey used to wear old baggy t-shirts. And she used to love coffee powder, and she even used to unscrew the top of the coffee bottle so that she could herself get some coffee powder to have and requisite her appetite. Okay, now after explaining all such things, the bell rang. And when the bell rang, all her classmates, they were roaming near her. And she was surrounded by all the girls, and they started asking lots of questions, that why didn't she ever tell them regarding the monkey, and what does the monkey eat, where does the monkey sleep, how old is she, each and everything. And everyone was asking her to let them show the monkey. In the meanwhile, the fantasy attained greater heights within me. I could see little Pepper, actually see her. And when one day a rat chewed a corner of my Sanskrit exercise book, pat came the reply, "I'm really sorry, Mrs. Rana. You see, my capuchin monkey is teething and she's chewing up everything inside. I'll get a new book and copy out of the exercises again." Okay. Now, when she was talking at the off time with her friends regarding the monkey, after that, their new period has started, that is the Sanskrit period. And that day, she has not brought her Sanskrit copy. So, the Sanskrit teacher, that is Mrs. Rana, she asked the little girl about her Sanskrit copy. And in the meanwhile, she attained another fantasy by imagining about the capuchin monkey whose name was Pepper in real. And she said that, you know, I'm extremely sorry, teacher. Actually, my capuchin monkey has started teething. And so she is chewing up everything, whatever she finds inside. And that day she had chewed my Sanskrit copy, some portion and a corner of my Sanskrit copy. Actually, the main thing is that Pepper had not chewed the Sanskrit copy, because Pepper was not present only. Pepper is nothing but a fantasized being, isn't it? Actually, a rat had chewed a corner of the girl's Sanskrit exercise book. But now if she says about the rat, then everyone will laugh at her, isn't it? And she will feel embarrassed. So here also she had added her imaginary skills and said that Pepper had chewed up her exercise book. No, no, Mrs. Rana's glasses glinted. That won't be necessary at all. But tell me, what are you going to do about the monkey's teething? Oh, we gave her ice cubes and baby chewy toys. You know the kind babies use? I saw the end of Pepper approaching with the onset of August, my birthday month. Fond as I had become of my fantasy pet, I wasn't about to miss my birthday party for her. So with a heavy heart, I killed her. I arrived in school with a long face and actual genuine tears. Okay, so after hearing her fantasized story, Mrs. Rana, that is the Sanskrit teacher, said that, okay, that's not a problem, but since your baby monkey has started teething, so what do you give her to eat? Then the little girl said that she gives her ice cubes and baby chewy toys, the kind of baby chewy toys which the human babies use. And you know what? See, now everyone knows that the little girl has a pet which is nothing but a capuchin monkey and whose name was Pepper, and she is a baby monkey. And her birthday month was August. Her birthday was approaching and she was about to invite all of her classmates, and all of her classmates are also eager to watch Pepper at her house when at her birthday party. So she was thinking that if everyone comes to know that Pepper was not actually present there, Pepper was nothing but an imaginary tale which the little girl had explained them, okay, then she will be extremely embarrassed. So she decided to what? She decided to kill Pepper imaginarily and say about her death the next day in the class. So students, let's see what happened. What's the matter? Asked everybody. Pepper died. Groups of distraught girls and even teachers surrounded me once more in hushed, grieving tones. Oh, poor Pepper, poor you. How did it happen? Came a question. We were going out. We had to leave her, but she managed to unlatch a window. She was so clever. They all nodded in agreement. They too had got to know her so well. Down the Gulmohar tree, she came. She tried to chase the car. We didn't see her. At the crossing at the main road, another car. And we all broke down together, weeping real tears for a make-believe monkey. I swallowed consoling Channa Bhaturas along with my guilt. To make doubly sure that no one mentioned Pepper at my house, I would burst into fresh tears every time someone so much as made a passing reference to monkeys. Surely, no one would be so cruel as to make me cry on my birthday. But there was someone so cruel. Rosemary Fernandez had been absent with a fever since the day Pepa had been killed. But Rosemary Fernandez was invited. Okay, that's the matter. Now, as I had told you children that her birthday month was approaching and everyone was eager to know about Pepper, and so finally the day has arrived when it was her birthday. So all her classmates would come, isn't it? So before that day at school, the little girl came with a heavy heart and told everyone that Pepper had died out of accident. That is, the little girl and her family would have to go out and they would have to leave her at home. But somehow the baby monkey managed to open the window and she came out and she had an accident. And instantly she died. So everyone was also feeling so sad for the poor little baby Pepper, the capuchin monkey. Now, after explaining everything in detail, the little girl was relieved. She knew that now no one would ask her about Pepper. Even if all the classmates are also invited to her birthday, no one would be so cruel enough to ask Pepper about her to her on her birthday at her house so that she would cry. But there was one girl whose name was Rosemary Fernandez. She knows everything about Pepper, but she had been absent due to fever since the day Pepper had been killed imaginarily. Okay, but that girl Rosemary Fernandez was also invited. Now that little girl, she knew that all her classmates would attend her birthday party, and since Pepper is no more and it is a very sad feeling, so no one would ask the little girl about Pepper. But Rosemary didn't know that Pepper had been killed. So there is quite a 100% chance of Rosemary Fernandez to ask in front of everyone to the little girl about Pepper. Now let's read and find out what happened next. They were all crowded into my room, bringing presents and good wishes. Rosemary Fernandez looked around expectantly and then in a voice as loud and clear as the proverbial bell, she asked, "I say, where's your monkey?" My elder sister stood at the door, gaping, and my gaze unwillingly went to meet hers. Mute, guilty, pleading, "Please, please keep your mouth shut." "Liar," she mouthed, no sound escaping her lips. My sister dashed away, unable to control her laughter any longer. But for the whole year to come, I had to fulfill her every whim and fancy under the dire threat that she would reveal the truth. I had to relent gracefully. This was all of 17 years ago, but I still remember Pepper, the capuchin monkey, with some fondness and warmth as I hear the faithful voice of Rosemary Fernandez once again ask, "I say, where's your monkey?" Okay. Now, as planned by the little girl, everyone was going on nicely and everything was going on in full swing at her birthday party. Okay. All her friends had arrived and all were enjoying. You know, there was a fear in the little girl's mind that Rosemary Fernandez, she doesn't know about Pepper's death, so she might ask, and the same thing happened. Rosemary Fernandez was clearly shouting and asking the little girl about the monkey. She was asking, "Where's your monkey? I want to see her." And at that time, the elder sister of the little girl was also standing there. She was awestruck. She was feeling, "Where does a monkey come here at our house?" She was looking at her younger sister, and her younger sister was also looking at her with some guilt, and she was silently pleading her elder sister not to say anything now. And her elder sister, she was calling her a liar, and since it was a funny incident, she couldn't control her laughter any longer. So you know what? So the narrator of this story She was none but the little girl, and she was saying that all these things happened 17 years ago. And after that day, that is her birthday, since she had lied everyone about Pepper the capuchin monkey, and the real truth was known only to her elder sister, so her elder sister used to threaten her by saying that if she didn't fulfill her every whim and fancy, that is her every wish, whatever she wanted, then her elder sister would reveal the truth of the imaginary and fantasizing story of Pepper the capuchin monkey to everyone. And you know, out of threat and out of fear, the little girl had to listen each and everything her elder sister used to say her to save herself from embarrassment. Okay. So children, this is a very interesting and funny story. Okay, so I hope you all have understood this chapter nicely, isn't it? I hope I could explain you all everything in detail. Do read the whole chapter carefully, each and everything properly, and do read the question answers which will be provided to you in due course of time, and get yourself prepared for each and everything, especially your exams, so that you can qualify with flying colors. Okay, so your two chapters for PT2 are over by now. Only your last chapter is left from book 6, that we will finish up during your next class. Clear? So students, this much for today. Thank you.